Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're in the Eastern Sierra for the opener at Bridgeport Reservoir for rainbows and brown trout. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. It's opening day for trout and we're launching at first light at Bridgeport Reservoir, a heavily planted put and take fishery, well known for its quality rainbow and brown trout.
A little sporty opener.
Today it looks like the wind will be the challenge.
We're up.
Yeah, so got a little wind to deal with this morning. Calling for sustained 15 with gust of 35. So sometimes you got to deal with that up here in the Eastern Sierra, but you know what? Big fish weather. So we're going to give them what we got. And reservoir is pretty low, so we're launching from what they call a bathtub. And it's a little bit interesting, but manageable, doable. I'll wait. I'll peg it here. And once you get in, then I'll pull back off. And then you guys can pull some of the rods out.
Yep, and, you got it, brother.
Last year, that thing was beautiful, just like these cripplers last year.
Cripplers on
fire. Fire tiger, beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, so we ran over here to the southwest side, get out of the wind, find some fish. We're right here off of Rainbow Point. It's typically been very, very productive for us. So we're gonna start here, run with the wind while we're setting rods, just to keep it a little easier, and hopefully we get some fish along the way, of course. But you know, certainly I think the fish will turn on once the sun hits the water. But a little calmer over here than what we were doing with the rim.
So we're gonna start with a couple different offerings, a couple small minnow plugs. Those have always been productive here. And then probably a couple cripplers imitating a wounded bait fish. Cripplers are always a favorite out here. So we'll start with a couple different things, see how it goes, and switch up from there. So we'll try a couple different scents just to see what they're interested in, and we'll put trout kokanee magic on this, and then probably use some trophy trout or predator because that was working really well last year. So so a couple of lines not on downriggers on the top line, going to run those way back, probably 150-200 feet, and then the downriggers we'll move them a little closer to the bottom, you know, 15 feet or so, and run those a little shorter set back just so we have a good spread.
So Adam, how far back are you thinking on these top lines, and that way I can set those rigger rods here?
Yeah, 150 to 200 feet on the top line.
Okay, yeah, I think I'm just about there. So we'll go ahead and put those in and knock them down about, what, 10 feet, we think, we'd say?
Right. Yeah, 10, 12 feet.
Just about there.
This baby ready to pound.
Yeah, so wind's not too bad down here. We got the boat. I feel like remote Mark over here. But between the kicker remote and the bow mount remote, we're rolling about 2.7 miles an hour. Perfect speed for the cripplers. Perfect speed for really everything we got out. So that should be the magic number, I'm hoping. And hopefully we'll get a decent little rainbow or even a big brown. But pretty fair weather down here right now. So right up over there, you can see the peaks and with the snow-capped mountains. We've got upper and lower Twin Lakes. Right on the other side of that, I believe, is Yosemite. So lower Twin can be phenomenal for some trophy browns. Upper Twin holds some kokanee, as well as some decent browns. They really do a heavy planting schedule out here as far as rainbows and browns. So that's why it's really highly sought after for the opener. So launched towards the dam this morning. It's a little bit deeper down there, obviously. Over here it's much shallower. We're only looking at 13 feet of water. There's definitely more weeds, a lot of bugs. These fish are kind of feeding mainly on bugs and other baby fish, whether it be, you know, trout or brown trout or, you know, that sort of thing. So they can kind of hide down here. This time of year it's pretty weed free, but if you hit this in the middle of summer, you can expect to see a lot of grass up on the surface. It's tough to troll down here. A lot of times you have to bait fish it. So this time of year it's better than it normally is. So but it can be productive. Very productive down here.
Bridgeport is not known for its traffic, but this small town in the Eastern Sierra, about 2 hours south of Reno, Nevada, is a classic example of the Old West. And just down the road a stretch is Bridgeport Reservoir. We've run to the calmer end of the lake looking to hook up with rainbows or brown trout.
So we're last rod here. We're gonna go ahead and put on a sling blade and a nightmare wedding ring. And we're gonna tip it with a little night crawler. Figure, you know, hey, you can't beat me putting it out. So hopefully these fish like it. Just some baby night crawlers here. We'll go ahead and split them in half. We're just looking for a tip. And just thread it right through like that. So we just put that down. It was down for about 5 seconds. You know what? It looked like it spit the hook, but we had an instant takedown on that worm trailer nightmare with that UV sling blade. So we're gonna bring that back in and make sure there's still some meat on there and some bait. We're gonna put it right back out. That did not take but just a second. I think I just literally set the downrigger, and as you can see, there's not much left of the bait. So it didn't take but a moment. With the nightmare, it's got black blades. We got high amount of contrast here in low light conditions. Dark colors work great. The sun has yet to hit the water. And then again, with that big thumper blade, it's definitely creating a disturbance down there. So I think it was a good choice to put this one out for sure. We're gonna put this out back at about 100, 125 feet. That's right where we had it, and down on the rigger about 7 feet. Hopefully duplicate the results.
Big old pelican.
You gotta watch out for those. Remember that one year? That one year when he caught that fish, it was all the way back there and twirling around on the surface, and fish got away, but I thought we were gonna hook that one.
That pelican just got to have a meal on us.
Hit that plug.
This morning, couldn't really see the water clarity too much. Once the sun hit it, you can see it's just chocolate milk. So we've been running some pretty natural colors, trying to match the hatch, so to speak. But I think we're gonna have to switch it up, go a little brighter, try to get something that'll stand out in this murky water.
Yeah, he's there.
Fish on. Putting my sunscreen on, and every time you're doing something else, that's when you get your bite. Like we were saying earlier, with this murky water, we wanted to move it into something brighter, catch the attention of the fish, and we moved into a really bright minnow plug, and sure enough, that's what we hooked up here. So yeah, he's starting to head shake just a little bit, but we'll see. Everyone's been catching browns this morning. We'll see if maybe we have a brown or rainbow. He's coming right here. Oh, there he goes. Oh, this one's on here.
I got that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, someone reel on that.
All right, this looks like a rainbow. Hold on now. All right, fish in the boat. All right, nice rainbow. Yeah, that's a great looking Bridgeport rainbow there. That's about what you'd expect out here. That's about the size you'd expect right there on a nice Bridgeport average rainbow. He really ate that plug, that's for sure.
Nice, coming close. Right here. Actually, that's a nice fish too. This is a pretty nice fish. I don't know what size on it. He's right here by the boat. And this is on a crippler. Head down for a little bit. And looks like a brown. From what I can see here.
Right here. Okay, right here.
Not ready, bro. Pretty decent fish. Oh, got him.
Nice
finish off.
So we got this this on a red-headed crippler. And there's a proven effective lures out here.
Welcome back to Bridgeport Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. The wind is picking up, but after a slow start, so is the fishing.
So go ahead and reset this crippler. Just caught that brown. Caught it on Procure Trophy Trout. Just like to put a little bit of that right in the cavity here. Holds in there tight and just slow releases, keeps that scent trail going. Check the action. It's a versatile lure. Definitely a windy day, and so you're going to get into the wind and slowing down and then going with the wind, speeding up. It's hard to control that. And the nice thing about crippler with the versatility of it is that it'll work well at slower speeds, and then when it picks up, it doesn't start to roll or spin. It just works faster and works harder for you. So great lure for windy conditions when the speed's all over the map.
All right, some nice fish. Oh, he's back there. You see him jumping. Got a little surface. Everybody we talked to on the radio has only been catching browns. We've the only ones that we know of that have caught a rainbow so far. We don't know what's on the line here, but maybe another nice rainbow. It's peeling a little drag, and it's looking to be a nice fish.
Pulled drag on me a couple times. Jumped out the water, did a little dance for us. Oh yeah.
Oh, oh come on. It's not there with it. All right. There we go.
Beautiful. That's a nice rainbow.
That is gorgeous.
That right there is a Bridgeport rainbow. That's a nice fish right there. Great eater. That's what we came out here for.
Good fish there.
So we're gonna try a Jay Fair fly here. This is the all-around best. I've caught a lot of fish on these flies. This is historically a bug lake a little later in the year. It's a little early, there's no bug hatch yet. But you know, definitely the fish are used to bugs around here. So we're gonna put this on, run it just right under the surface, and pull it along. And with this wind, it should pull along nice, have some good action on its own. With this wiggle disc right in front of it, I'm just gonna run it right up against the nose, give it a subtle action, and then the wind will help tug it along and give it more action on its own. Otherwise, you could pull it further up and run a bobber stop or a bead or something to give it that more whipping action if it were to be calm out and you needed a little more help from it in that regard. So we'll give it a whirl and see how it goes. All right. Fish on in the wind on that bright colored minnow plug again. Yeah, it was funny. I was just going to change out my other line, and as soon as you're doing something else, bam, there he is. He's trying to run left on me here. Yeah, he feels pretty good. He's just kind of staying down.
Staying down for sure.
Yep. There he goes. Oh yeah, nice fish. Nice rainbow, it looks like. Yeah, it's a good rainbow. Looks like maybe a 3 or 4 pound rainbow here. He's not. He's definitely not ready. Oh yeah, there he goes. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Nothing like a hard fighting rainbow looking at the mountains. Sure.
Good fish. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he might be a little bit.
That's a nice fish.
Yeah. This is one of those trophy trout they put in here with the tags in them.
Yep.
So he's not foul to us at all. Man, look at the color on him. Holy moly.
That is a gorgeous fish.
Wow. What a beauty. Yeah, he just got a tag in him, so that's, he's cleanly hooked, so that's perfect, right in the mouth.
Okay. Oh! Oh no!
What are you gonna do? He went to jump, put the rod down, that's what you're supposed to do, and he shook it. But
that was a good one.
It's a dandy for sure. Ah!
Welcome back to Bridgeport Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. It's late morning, and despite the big wind, we're hooking up with some beautiful fish and licking our wounds after losing a Bridgeport Trophy Rainbow.
Gorgeous fish.
Wow.
What a beauty.
Okay. Oh, no. They plant a handful of trophy large rainbows in here. I would guess that one was probably pushing the 6-7 pound. You know, this is a plant to take lake. Not sure if they're triploid or not. I think they might be, but that was definitely, that was a good fish right there.
Man, yeah, that's rough. He was, he must not have been hooked super good, but God, that was a nice fish. He was beautiful. You see that pink on him?
Yeah, no, fish on right here. Started just rip and drag. We got a fish on there too.
About three.
Doubles.
Should be good.
Double. Got another one here.
Sorry, just peel and drag right off the bat.
Doubles.
Got about 15 feet here. Oh, he's right here. Nice little brown. He ain't done yet. Oh boy, one little drag, staying down, kind of realized it just got hooked up. Buddy.
Nice work. I'll steer the boat. You guys handle the fish?
Yeah.
All right. Good job.
Way to go. Hey. Again, catch and keep lake. So we'll probably keep these, and Brandon wants to take some fish home, so these should eat real well. They're not giants. And yeah.
Yeah, so Bridgeport is pretty consistent year over year. Small bait, so we run real small minnow plugs, and you know, it really was all about getting that contrast with the water. You know, real murky water, small minnow plug with some good bright colors on it, and we've had, you know, back-to-back hits there. You'll see the lost one we had there, the bigger fish, but all three came in the last 15 minutes, and it seems like the bite window has opened up. It's been slow this morning, but there's always going to be a window where they're on, and I think right now we've hit that window. So small bait, big fish.
Yeah, buddy. So the wind is forecasted to bump up to, they were saying, 45 to 50 mile an hour gusts. So it's getting sporty out here right now. It's a solid 25 mile an hour with occasional gust, I would say, to 35 at the moment.
I brought that one a little way.
A little difficult to keep the boat going in the right direction, but we're making it happen. We're making these fish come to the boat. So it's the best you can ask for.
Literally just set this down about 10 seconds ago. And as soon as I set it on the clip and got the rod set, just took it right off the clip, hammered it, trying to run me out to this. Hey, you can leave that rod. I think it's fine.
Yeah.
So this fish is way off to the side.
Better safe than sorry.
All right. Another example of a really bright lure. Just put this bright lure down. There he is. Just with this really muddy water, it seems like that's kind of the ticket. This looks like another decent little rainbow, maybe, or yeah, a little hard to say at this point. Looks like maybe a small brown. I'm gonna bring them your way there, buddy. Box. We found that bite window slow this morning, but there's always that period where they're gonna turn on, and we've caught four or five now in the last hour or so. He really hammered that. I think it's a circular cumulonimbus. My Uncle Mac used to say, and that's probably not the correct meteorological term for it, but when you see those clouds and they look like a UFO, it's windy as hell.
I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there would be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.